A trough is 4 meters long, 2.5 meters wide, and 5 meters deep. The vertical cross-section of the trough parallel to the end is shaped like an isosceles triangle with a height of 5 meters and a base which is on top of 2.5 meters. So the trough is pictured here. The trough is full of water that has a density of 1,000 kilograms per meters cubed. We want to find the amount of work in joules required to empty the trough by pumping the water over the top. We'll also use the acceleration due to gravity given here. Before we set this up though, if an object is moving along a straight line by a continuously varying force f of x, then the work done by the force as the object is moved from x equals a to x equals b is given by this definite integral. To understand why this works, if we consider one increment of work, which would be the amount of work required to pump one layer of water out of the tank, it would be equal to the force times the distance increment. And as we found the sum of more and more increments of work, it would approach the total work, and therefore the limit as n approaches infinity of the sum of these increments of work from I equals 1 to n would equal the total work, which we know is equal to this definite integral. So to help us set up this integral, we'll find the increment of work required to pump one layer of water out of the tank, which again is equal to force times the distance increment. So we'll determine the amount of work required to pump this green layer of water out of the tank, and we'll use this to set up the definite integral. Notice how to find the force though. We know force is equal to mass times acceleration, but we don't know the mass of this layer of water, but we know mass is equal to density times volume. We know the density, so let's begin by determining the volume of this layer of water. Well, the thickness of this layer of water would be delta x sub I. If this edge is 4 meters, then so is this edge. But we still have to determine this length here in terms of x. And we can do this using similar triangles by taking a vertical slice of this trough. But before we do that, let's also label this length and this length. Well, if we let this be x sub I, then the distance that the water must be pumped over the top would be 5 meters minus x sub I, or just 5 minus x sub I. So we'll use these when we take our vertical slice to write this width in terms of x. So now we'll take the vertical slice, which we see here. And again, we have similar triangles. We have this small isosceles triangle, and we have this large isosceles triangle. But because they're similar, we can now write a proportion involving w. We can say 2.5 is the w as 5, the total height of the large isosceles triangle, again as 5 is to x. So we have the base is to the base as the height is to the height. Now if we cross multiply, we'll have 5w equals 2.5x. So 5w equals 2.5x, divide both sides by 5. Notice how this gives us w, the width, is equal to 1/2x. So going back to our previous slide, we can label this width as 1/2x sub I, which means the volume of this layer, since we have a right rectangular prism or a box, the volume is equal to length times width times height, where the length is 4, the width we just found as 1/2x sub I, and the height, which is the thickness, is delta x sub I. So this product gives us the volume. Now that we have the volume, we can find the force, where the force is equal to the density, which is given as 1,000, times the volume, which we just found. Notice 4 times 1/2 is 2. And a, the acceleration due to gravity, is given as 9.8. So now that we have the force, and we already found the distance as 5 minus x sub I, this distance here, we can now find the increment of work required to pump this layer of water out of the trough. Delta W sub I is equal to, again, force times distance. But let's go ahead and put this delta x sub I on the end. So we'd have 1,000 times 2x sub I times 9.8 times 5 minus x sub I times delta x sub I. So this is the increment of work to pump out one layer of water, and therefore the total work, and therefore the actual work, is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of these increments of work, which we can write as the sum from I equals 1 to n of this product here. And we know this gives us a definite integral where the work would be equal to the integral of 1,000 times 2x times 9.8 times 5 minus x. And this delta x sub I gives us dx. We'll integrate from the bottom of the tank to the top, or from 0 to 5. Let's go ahead and evaluate this on the next slide. Notice how 1,000, 2, and 9.8 are just constants. Let's go ahead and factor that out. And since 1,000 times 2 times 9.8 is 19,600, this is equal to 19,600 times integral from 0 to 5 of x times 5 minus x. Let's go ahead and distribute. So we have 5x minus x squared. Now we'll find the antiderivative. So the antiderivative of 5x would be 5 times x squared over 2, or 5 halves times x squared, minus the antiderivative of x squared would be x to the third divided by 3, or 1/3 x to the third. Now we'll substitute 5 for x, then 0 for x, then find this difference. So we'll have 5 halves times 5 squared minus 1/3 times 5 cubed. Notice when x is 0, these are both 0. So now let's go to the calculator. We have 19,600 times, well, 5 halves times 5 squared, that would be 125 divided by 2, minus 1/3 times 5 cubed would be 125 divided by 3. So this comes out to approximately 408,333.3333. The units here would be kilograms times meters squared divided by seconds squared, which is joules. This would be the amount of work in joules required to pump the water out of the trough. I hope you found this helpful.